Hey, what's up, what's up? It's your number one coke boy, Chinx, and you're watching AGTV. Cousin.
She got a sister or friend?
She's really a Kardashian, that's your cousin. Yeah, you bought that shit for a second.
Couple bottles, got a couple switches. Couple bands, got a couple bitches. Got the whole block sewn up. Ask them who it is, they gon' say a couple niggas. Tell my niggas, grab a couple niggas. 100 deep inside the club. Now them niggas got a problem with a couple niggas. Keep the burner on me for a couple niggas. Only reason I don't fuck with niggas, cause I made it from the mother.
Some like crazy stories on that happened on tour with like groupies and
stuff. I tell the same shit all the time.
Yeah, you fucked some chick's girl, some guy's girl, and he was out playing outside or something?
Yeah.
Anything lately though? Like some crazy shit?
Nah, I just been watching it in the studio, man. I got, right. You know what I'm saying?
That cocaine riot. Dope.
But yeah, it was just, you know, the story about one time I was with, I forgot what state we was in. And take a girl back to the room from the venue. And after, I had knocked at the door on my hotel room door. It's a nigga. So he, you know, the girl goes out and she's like, so I stick my head out to make sure everything was all right. And then I see a guy out there and I hear him tell her, baby, you finished? Everything good? And she's like, yeah, baby, we good. So then they just walk off. So that shit was like super weird.
So he was like, yo, dog, your pleasure.
And he wasn't a pimp neither.
Right.
He didn't have pimp nowhere on his, just, I didn't read that. So last thing I said, I had to be a baby father. And when I called to ask her what it was, that's exactly, she said, oh, nothing, that was just my baby father, that was nothing.
For real?
No, weird shit. Weird shit, man.
Yeah, let me ask you another thing. Is the hip-hop police real? You ever get, like, followed by
them? The hip-hop police is realer than a motherfucker, man.
So you've been...
I ain't gonna say I get followed, man, right. But you know what I'm saying? They definitely be at all our venues and shit, you know what I'm saying? You know, when you're doing legal, you know, hip-hop is legal. When you're doing legal business, it's like, you know, these motherfuckers know you on a first name basis and they outside all my shows. So, you know what I'm saying? Just so you don't rub them the wrong way, you gotta keep a certain respect level with them because they outside every venue. You know what I'm saying? They definitely out there. You know what I'm saying? The same unit, too. It's the same unit.
Same
for New York, you see them, it's all the venues, man. Never switch up. And they consistent, too.
So, what do you think about, like, the dude Eric Garner, the guy who was killed by the officers in Staten Island?
Oh, that's some foul shit. That was some real fucked up.
Matter of fact, it was really fucked up that one of the cops, he was like waving to the camera while he was already dead.
So one of the cops was waving to the camera while this shit happened? That's crazy, I didn't know that.
Yeah, you gotta see the whole thing, it's on YouTube. He's like waving to this shit.
Oh, that's some wild shit, man. But that was some real, that's some real unjust foul shit, man. Like, you know, that man said he couldn't breathe about 11 times, I believe, right? Something like that?
Mm-hmm.
I can't breathe. And they smoked him. That's crazy, man. That just goes to show you, man, protect your body out here, man, because these law enforcement, they don't give two fucks about nothing we trying to do. You know what I'm saying? So be careful. White, black, it don't matter. Like, they don't give a fuck about nobody no more that day. You know what I'm saying?
Because what I said could have been me, could have been you, could have been my boy right here.
Yeah, it could have been you. What are you?
I'm Spanish, bro.
But you look white.
Exactly. You never know, man. They don't give a fuck.
They don't give a fuck, man. You hanging out with me, you just as Spanish or black as me, so it don't matter. They done smoked your ass, too.
Man, if you could switch bodies with any celebrity, who would it be?
If I could switch bodies with any celebrity, that's a wild-ass question, my nigga.
I got some random shit, bro.
You know, I could switch bodies. That shit don't even sound right. Can you be worried that about switching bodies?
Some booty shit, I don't know. Bill Gates or some shit?
Huh?
Bill Gates or some shit?
If I could switch...
Bodies and
careers.
Career? Yeah,
definitely be a nigga. You know, rest in peace. Swiss homie that passed away from Apple. Steve Jobs, Bill Gates, you know what I'm saying? One of them niggas that really left a mark out here. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Q Hef, definitely.
Hell yeah. The old homie?
For sure.
What's your favorite cartoon growing up?
Favorite cartoon growing up? My favorite cartoon growing up was Bionic Six.
Bionic Six?
When I was a little kid, I used to watch Bionic Six.
Mm-hmm. Well, so you you read any good books?
When I was locked up.
Yeah.
That's crazy. But about the only time I ever read it in my life was when I was in prison. Mm-hmm. Fuck it, man. It's the truth, man. Interesting shit. I read a lot of books on The Mind. When I was locked up, man. And then, of course, those nasty-ass hood novels. You know what I'm saying? Read about 1,000 of them shits. Read a couple books in prison.
Mm-hmm.
Jail University.
Jail University? You got any, like, a...
J.U.
Did you get, like, a GED or anything like that?
Yeah, I got that then, too. I had to do something with my time. Couldn't just go to Wade Shack and play basketball, so I definitely got my GED. I passed it on the first try, too.
Let's go, man. I don't even got my shit, man.
That's what I'm saying. Maybe you need to get locked up.
Yeah.